Let's play Counter-Strike Source. Today the Nuke map again from the Counterterrorist side in a 2-on-2 or 3-on-3 scenario. The position we are going to take a look at is the cat position, so the catwalk which is above and around the A spot. This video shows now different scenarios of my movement down from the cat to support my troops or just to hold the A position itself. The big advantages of this position are that you, in almost all of the cases, you can see the enemies before they see you. You will see their legs, you will see their torso, and they will always have to look up to you, so you can probably take them down before they see you at all. You can hear over the whole map. Wherever you position yourself, you have a hearing sight, so if you position yourself over the entrance from the outside, you can hear over the whole outside area. If you position yourself on the ramp side, you can hear over the whole ramp area, etc. And you can even hear, standing in the cat room itself, where the ladder goes up, you can even hear if somebody on the B side shoots down the windows to access the computer room. You can hold the A spot against multiple enemies, and the cat of course is very good for defensive movement if you don't see any enemies. It is, yeah, very secure. You can almost go out and leave the spot or move from all the sides on the map available. The disadvantages are that after the spot is stormed maybe by terrorists and you are sitting on the cat alone, there is almost no way to escape, because you can only go down to the A spot or take the ladder if you reach it. And having only this little small catwalk of, I don't know, 80 centimeters or a meter, you are very vulnerable against all types of grenades. So you can get smoked away, you can get flashed very effectively. And if you are standing in the cat room, it's very likely that terrorists will throw grenades in there, anticipating that you are standing there. And you really have to have a good headset on this position, because it's most important that you hear the enemy. So what are the tactics? How will the game look like? I'm playing in a 2-on-2 or 3-on-3 scenario. There are two positions on the A spot. One guy will go up the ladder in the cat, and one guy will cover the door and the outside. He might go up with you in the cat as well, but he can go on the outside as well using the main entrance to spot A and camping there. And in a 3-on-3, of course, the third guy will be on the ramp. In the beginning of the game, it's very important that only you or the door guy got the game by hearing. So don't show yourself, make visible contacts as late as possible. The ramp guy doesn't has to do anything in the beginning if there is a ramp guy, because you should hear if they are rushing the ramp, and if they are sneaking to the ramp, you should see them before they see him. Always take into account that you, as the cat guy with upper position, you are only responsible for the A spot. You of course may support the guys on the B spot if necessary, but the A spot is your thing. So take into account that you have to play as defensive as possible. You even may stay hidden until they plant the bomb. Prevent them from planting the bomb. You can of course delay it by flashing the spot quite effectively. Since it is a very popular position in the cat, you have to pay big attention that you vary your position quite often, or as often as possible, because the enemy, if they have some experience, they will probably already pre-fire or pre-aim on the most common positions. If you play the game, you will experience that there are some spots where the terrorists will pre-aim for you coming out of the cat, and they will be most likely on the outside with a AWP sniper rifle from the red container or from the mech hall, because from there they have a pretty good aim at you coming out, and they will be probably standing on the ramp or down in this little hallway from the ramp to the cat to shoot you as soon as you come down the ladder. So if you move from the cat position to the B spot, it is really advisable always to take the path over A, and there you have to pay attention, because falling down from the cat might cost you some life points you need later. So if you just drop down, normally I think it is 20 life points, so if you go down from the cat over the A spot, take care that you either jump over the forklifter, over the big metallic entrance, or over the ventilation systems. Yeah, listen to your mates for B and give them commands for A, as long as you have a clue what's going on, and always leave the cat as late as possible. Only leave the cat spot if you really know, or if your teammates really know, that the terrorists are going to plant the bomb on B. Since the terrorists will find out that you will always be standing in the cat, they will most likely try to come from the outside, come from down under the cat, maybe they will stand on the counter-terrorist spot and try to catch you from there. So it is very likely that the terrorists will fake a B attack on the B spot, maybe even take the ramp guy down, but don't panic and don't go too fast. And yeah, if you trust yourself, and if you trust in the headset you have, and maybe in the sound card you have, then the cat position is very good to be defended against enemies coming from the outside or coming down from the ramp. And take care, of course, that you always have a diffuser with you. But that's more general advice than useful or especially for the cat position. That's basically it. There is nothing big more to explain about this position. It has to do a lot with in improvising, and yeah, you can improve your improvising by getting a lot more experience and playing the map many times. Now just enjoy the clips and the super awesome, not copyright protected music. We'll be right back. yeah, once again, I thank everybody for watching the video. I hope you maybe could learn some stuff or got some new insight. It is very important with Counter-Strike Source that you just practice as often and as much as possible. And if you like the video, subscribe to my channel. If you have some further questions or commentary, don't hesitate to contact me. And I hope to see you next week. Goodbye.